Hi everyone, this is Xueshi Lu. I'm pleased to present our work, iText, hands-free text entry and manual keyboard for augmented reality systems. I'm from Xinjiang Dong Liverpool University, China. This is a joint work with colleagues from the University of Melbourne. Augmented reality head-mounted displays have become more practical and appealing. They can in potential help users complete everyday tasks such as checking emails, browsing information, and doing online chatting. However, in current AR headsets, there are still two main open challenges to overcome for efficient and useful text entry. First, devices like the HoloLens request a pinch-based approach to select keys. This kind of mid-air input can quickly lead to arm fatigue. Second, due to their small see-through displays, virtual interfaces can occlude users from seeing objects behind the interface, which can cause injuries when users are standing or moving. In this research, we present iText, a text entry technique for AR headsets that is hands-free and is based on an imaginary keyboard. With iText, users can enter text without using their hands on an invisible keyboard interface with minimal occlusion. We evaluated its performance and usability with three hands-free selection mechanisms. The first is detect, which allows users to select letters by hovering the cursor on the keys for a certain period of time. That is a dual time. The second is G-type, which allows users to enter text by making continuous gestures with their head. With E-type, users blink eyes to trigger selections. Our first user study explored whether users could type on an imaginary keyboard and collect endpoints of users' input. We followed a Wizard of Oz approach. As such, we did not use a decoding algorithm, and the system would always display the correct text regardless of users' selection points. This way allowed us to collect unbiased typing behaviors and endpoints of trigger selections. Here are the results of study 1. The pictures show the imaginary key distributions depicted by confidence ellipses. We found that users could recall key positions with high accuracy. These results indicate that D-type is more stable, with smaller standard deviations of the key positions. We used the data collected from study 1 to derive our typing decoders, which would be used to provide suggestion words to the users during the typing process. In this project, we have two decoders. A statistical decoder was for D-type and E-type. It consists of a spatial model that gives the probability distributions regarding key locations on the keyboard. It also has a language model that determines probable words based on the corpus. Another is a gesture decoder designed for G-type. The algorithm infers the most probable word by measuring the similarities of a gesture shape based on the usual distance between it and the letters. With the typing decoders in place, we conducted a second study to evaluate the effectiveness of the three hands-free selection mechanisms in terms of typing speed, error rate, and the subjective feedback. The study followed a between-subjects design with 18 participants from a university campus. Each had to transcribe 40 phrases in 5 blocks. Then they were asked to fill a user experience questionnaire and the NASA text load index. Text entry speed was measured in words per minute. Word error rate was based on the minimum word distance approach, which was the smallest number of word edits needed to transform the transcribed string into the desired string. Pairwise comparisons show that E-type was significantly faster than D-type and G-type. With E-type, users could reach almost 12 words per minute. The word error rate was low in the final block among the three mechanisms, while G-type was slightly better than E-type and D-type. It was slightly but not significantly better. The subjective feedback shows that E-type was more preferred by the participants. Because E-type showed an obvious advantage in text entry speed and user preference, We further explored its performance with a more extended use to see how long users would need it to reach peak text entry speed and if eye fatigue would affect performance and usability. To this end, we ran a third 5-day study with eType. 5 participants completed 16 phrases each day and were asked to raise their eye fatigue. Participants achieved average text entry rates of 13.04 and 13.77 words per minute on day 4 and day 5, respectively. Their eye fatigue decreased over the course of 5 days as they became more familiar with the blinking mechanism. Before concluding, we propose 3 potential application scenarios for iText. First, iText could be a practical approach for text entry while walking. Users can enter text and still be able to see clearly nearby surrounding objects. It will allow reducing the possibility of accidents. Second, iText makes it possible to achieve text entry on an overlapping interface. For example, in this scenario, the user could type in search keywords and still have a good view of the lecture and the blackboard. With iText, there is a possibility of design interfaces with reduced overlaps. Third, iText could also be implemented in VR headsets. As shown in the picture, the player can reply to an incoming text while still playing the game without significant interruption. To summary, the results of the 3 studies show a solid case for iText for text entry in AR devices. The first study shows that users could perform text entry on a Magic Keyboard in AR. The second study explored 3 hands-free selection mechanisms based on dual gestures and eye blinks. While the 3 are feasible, blink-based selection outperformed the other 2 in text entry speed and subjective feedback. The third 5-day study shows that iText with eye blinks could support users to achieve a typing speed of 13.77 words per minute on the last day with very low eye fatigue. In short, iText is an efficient hands-free text entry technique for augmented devices. This avoids eye fatigue and has an occlusion-free keyboard interface. Thanks for your listening.